Hi, okay. Good evening. Welcome to the Northeast. We do this all kinds of, all times of the year. Coffee roasting. First ever actual roast. Ever. TM. This is on a Kaldi New Wide 400. I think, considering how small the business is, I spoke with the CEO, so I'm gonna assume it's a hand-built roaster by a machine shop somewhere in the South Korea. The good one. It's got a Center 306, which is a digital thermometer with two thermocouples, one exhaust and one bean temperature probe. We are going to try our hand at roasting coffee here. I have Artisan open. It's an open source roast graphing software. We're going to try our hand at our very first drum roast. I honestly don't know how I want to do this on. I'm just going to start recording when I hit start. Well, actually at the moment it's not recording anything because my thermometer isn't even on. So that should turn on. I'm getting two readings, 10.8, 12.5 Celsius. I'm going to make sure that we're getting those numbers. We are. We're seeing 10.7 exhaust temp and 12.6 bean temperature. I guess that triangle would stand for delta. But that doesn't seem right. Delta bean temp of what? What's the delta for? Whatever. I guess I'll hit start. Is when... Okay. Yep. Okay. So I'm going to try that again. When we put our beans in. So... Gas on. Gas is on. I am going to hit the start button to make sure that I can see the temperatures changing. That's full heat. That's full beans. I don't think we're going to use full heat. I think...
Maybe in the cold, it will actually... I would stick it full until...
I need to turn on the... There we go. Turn the switch on. We're seeing temperature rising. Seeing bean temps going up and exhaust temp also going up. My glasses just fogged up because I put my head over the exhaust. I don't know where the funnel is. Oh, there it is. Because I need to do some work in the background because I didn't do this ahead of time. I got a funnel. That goes up there. I need to pre-weigh some beans. So I'm going to do that while I'm out here. So I brought my Pario scale and some Colombian beans, the same as the ones we pan roasted a couple weeks ago. I'm gonna set this scale up here. This is very makeshift, and obviously you can tell we're doing it in the dead of night. Very smart. That's what smart people do. We're gonna do about, I don't know, let's say 200, just as a start. The Wide 400, as the name would suggest, has an upper limit of 400 grams. That doesn't mean you should do 400 grams, because you'll have a more uneven roast the more beans you have in there. I haven't tried it, so I can't say for certain how uneven that really is, but in time, I plan on doing a lot of coverage on this, because seemingly nobody has. I went a little over there. I'm just going to take some out. 201, that's fine. That's fine. Because we're going to lose a lot of that temperature, or a lot of that... mass. Reason being, because these beans are full of moisture and they're gonna lose that when they're roasted. So I think we're gonna lose around 1/6.
What's the target charge temperature?
Target charge, I want to say, is 200 Celsius, but I could be wrong. I honestly don't remember.
I would say maybe that would be something to look up.
Okay. It's smoking up a storm. I don't know if that's from the gas or the temperature outside, because it is well below freezing at this point.
Yeah.
Coffee, roast, charge, temperature. let's see. Charge temperature. I am not sure. Let's try Hell City. Oh, they're gonna charge me money for the class. Right. Okay. And it should take about 20 minutes for it to... Temperature 180 degrees C for a green bean 350 grams. So...
Okay. Alright.
Okay. Oh, man. Okay, so we're getting up to the drop temperature, or the charge temperature, which is... In the Kaldi's video, they had it at 180 degrees for a 350 gram in. This is 200, so that's 150 grams less. But there's 180. And I hit charge. I can find it. And in they go. I've marked it as charge. We're going to see the temperature drop down because we just put in a bunch of cold beans. And then we're going to hit dry end by the time the temperature turns around and stops decreasing. So there's the beans in there. You can see through the sight glass. I put my head there, you can kind of see it a little better, so the light's not getting in the way. So those are going to be green for a while. I think dry is once it's done with the yellowing phase, they're going to turn a little yellow, and we're going to see those numbers stop decreasing. Maybe I can even turn down the heat a little bit, so... I don't know.
I think you look good.
I put it back to where it was, I just don't want to mess it up. So as we can see, those projection lines are going to start to flatten out. I think that's when we'll call that the turning point, but I don't think we have a turning point button. But we'll see in a moment what happens. I can't entirely tell. Still green. Still green, I think. But it's starting to lose the skin. So, this is turning point here. It says TP right there. It's actually changed. It actually marked it for us. The turning point, see? At 1 minute 21 seconds, at a certain temperature, it flipped, and now it's increasing. So, we're going to start to see the numbers get closer and closer to each other, as in the disparity between, or rather the delta between, the bean temperature and the exhaust temperature. We'll see them start to get closer to each other. Check the beans every now and again, see what they look like. Some are turning green, some are turning yellow. Put these back in there. Some chaff flying about. Still green, so we're gonna leave them in there as to not disturb them. See what happens. They're projected to meet right around, what's that bottom number? 8 minutes? Before 8 minutes, they're projected to basically be around the same temperature. 7-8 minutes. So we'll see how that goes.
Why do you see that?
And looking where they meet.
Oh.
Where's the point of intersection? At what point of time?
Uh-huh.
Got it. Not that that's... I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing that they meet at that point or if they should meet sooner, but... It's actually extremely quiet. So I don't know if we could say that this is... I'd say they're still a bit green. They haven't entered... the yellowing phase entirely.
I need a stool. Sit down.
Still very green. We're slightly change the heat to be a little warmer and try to push them to get through that yellowing phase.
I think a pressure gauge is going to be helpful so we can make a judgment based upon what the numeric reading is on the pressure.
Yeah. because now those numbers are set to meet far beyond 8 minutes. I think they're supposed to meet a little more. So those are yellow now, see? Starting to get some yellow beans. Yellow beans. I'd almost mark that as the dry end, because I'd say at that point they aren't green anymore, so that means they're mostly dry now. See? They're nice and yellow, kind of a golden color. So now we're going to be shooting for first crack, which I think should come around the 6 minute mark, six or seven minutes. First crack is when you'll sort of have a light to medium roast. Oh, it smells incredible. It smells like warm bread. I can't feel my toes, but I guess it's worth it because we have fresh coffee.
But you have no shoes. Oh, you do have shoes on.
I do have shoes, yes. Yep. So now they're starting to brown. Some of these beans, if you look inside the chamber there, it's starting to come through a little bit more brown. Sight glass, I should say. So that's... I think they look a lot more brown on camera than they are in real life, I'll tell you that. I think the light gives them a little bit more of that reddish, kind of hazel brown color that we're looking for. Now the bean temperature is actually reaching the charge temperature that we had before. I don't remember if that's supposed to be super significant or not, as in when we reach that temperature, if it'll start to crack or not, but...
Oh, ooh, first crack!
No, not the first one. That's just an oddball.
Oh!
No, that's... You'll know.
I'm so excited.
Trust me. When you hear first crack, you'll know. It won't stop cracking. All of them will crack. So those are kind of like on their way to being a light roast. They still aren't developed yet, but... When we hear first crack, we're going to want to turn the temperature down a little to kind of... drag out that first crack so that they can develop in that temperature range a little more so as to not over, you know, heat them. I need to remember that turning the heat down is clockwise. So you go upwards to turn it down, which kind of makes no sense, but that's okay. Because the bottom is where it's hottest. So if we're looking at the beans, they're starting to get around that medium. There it is. Yeah, so we're starting to hear first crack. If I could find my bloody cursor, that'd be nice. Where is it? Oh shit, my computer's like freaking out. So there's first crack.
Heat down a little bit.
Yeah, heat down to kind of try to prolong that. Got it there. I'll try to keep them in that range a little bit. Coming up on the 8 minutes, so we're a little bit long.
This is why we do this outside.
The wind is blowing about, so that might throw a wrench in our roast. That might drop the temperature on us. Yeah, it is. It's dropping off.
Maybe the temperature needs to be tweaked back up if you're concerned about the temperature dropping.
No, it's okay. It's fine. See, it actually indicated a drop temperature for us.
Well, that was probably you changing the burner, right?
The burner. Actually, no, it's just it clicked itself. It's having trouble.
Okay.
So that would call that first crack end. But look at these beans. That's like a medium roast. Like light medium. I might even call it at that, to be honest.
Okay, you gonna start cooling?
Yeah, let's start cooling. So now we're gonna get into... Oh, shit. that's our first roast.
Close it.
There they are. In our makeshift. Cooler. I want to get something to agitate it with, but I guess your hand is probably fine, right?
Oh, that's cooling real fast. Real fast.
So there they are. That's 200 grams in. We're going to check again what they weigh afterwards. It's probably going to be a lot less. You're probably wondering, what is this ridiculous cooling setup? Well, it's a bucket with a sieve in it. Or for us Americans, you would call it a strainer. English, it's a sieve. And then we have it with an outlet to our shop vac in the garage. And as you can tell, they come out of the roaster at about 200 degrees, and I can hold them. So it does a really damn good job, I gotta say. And it pulls some of the chaff off of them too, which is really good. So that's excellent.
Those are already cool.
Yeah, that's cool to the touch. I mean, I could put that in a box right now and call it. That's it. That's perfect. Look at those.
Okay.
Look at those.
It's a cool end.
Yeah, cool end.
I had hit the drop.
Yeah, I know. I didn't hit it when I pressed the button. So that's the roast.
There you go.
It was probably very bad, and I'm sure any master roaster will make fun of me in the comments, but I want you to. I want you to tell me how to make this better, because I'm learning here, and it can only get better from here, right? So that's the first roast on my end with this Kaldi Wide 400, and stay tuned, because we'll do a lot more coverage on this roaster on this channel, because I know there's a distinct lack of that on the internet, so stick around. Face. The red, like, yeah, it's cold, man. So we're back inside. Couldn't feel my toes. The moment the roast finished, my adrenaline kind of wore off and I started to freeze. So we rushed back in some good light. That's what we got. I'd say that's kind of a light roast. Light, maybe medium, I guess you could say. But I'd say light because you can see on the inside the husk. You can still see the color. That's kind of a telltale sign of a light roast, so I probably could have dragged it out a little longer or tried to extend the crack, but it's okay. So I wanted to weigh and see what the weight is afterwards. We had 200 grams in, so if I, you know, carefully, keyword carefully, try to get these back into the first bowl that they were in, we'll see what the weight is. And they might not even fit because of how much more bulk. Ugh. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. There's so much fatter now that they've cracked open.
Oh, man. I think we're going to need a bigger bowl.
Gonna need a bigger bowl. I got a bigger bowl. Don't worry.
Well, you could use one of these.
Yeah, that's true, actually. Okay, and it's probably lighter, too, so the accuracy will be higher. Okay, so we're going to try that out again. That's actually perfect. Dump these back in. So we got 115, a little more to go. And I picked up all but one, I think. But anyway, there you go. 170 grams from 201. So what, we lost 30 grams? A little less than 30 grams of weight lost. And that's from moisture. God, we were talking about this earlier. Moisture and maybe one other thing. Oh, the chaff. Right. Obviously, chaff doesn't weigh a whole lot, but could play a role. But nonetheless, lost 30 grams. That's the chaff over there. So that was a Colombia Medellin coffee. Roasted on the Kaldi. We're going to let that sit for maybe a day or two to let it kind of degas. I know some people will put them in bags, but I'm just going to let them sit in the open air so that there's no like gas buildup or whatever. And I also don't have any bags to put them in yet, but they'll probably sit here for a few days, stick them in the Eureka, maybe pull a few shots and make a V60 and see how they taste in a couple different diversities. Again, I don't know what I'm doing, so this isn't roasted for espresso. It's not roasted for drip or whatever. It's just green beans that are no longer green, and I made them not green, so I will take it. I'll see how they taste. I'll try to read a little more about, you know, telltale signs of good or bad flavor for, you know, roasts. And I'll try to read up.